हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। दिस वीडियो लेसन मॉड्यूल नंबर 11 ऑन कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड्स ब्रॉट यू बाय विज्ञान ग्लोबल जन स्कूल्स हैदराबाद। माई सेल्फ वेंकट रेड्डी पेरम, टीचिंग फैकल्टी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्नड अबाउट होमोलोगस सीरीज, definition, examples and characteristic properties. Okay, so today let me introduce one of the very important concept in this carbon and its compounds. But before, let me ask few questions in order to test your previous knowledge. Dear students, do you have any idea about physical and chemical changes? Yes. What are chemical changes? Yes, you are correct. So, during chemical changes, new substances are formed. So, the change in which a new substance is formed is called a chemical change. Yes. So, chemical changes leads to chemical reactions or chemical properties. Now, in this chapter, carbon and its compounds, do you know how many chemical properties are present in our textbook? Yes. No idea? Yes. Today, our topic is that. What is that? Chemical properties of carbon and its compounds or carbon compounds. So, without delay, let me start the session by introducing the title. What is that? Chemical properties of carbon compounds. What is the, my dear students? What is that? Chemical properties of carbon compounds. So, chemical properties of carbon compounds. So, this is the topic meant for today. So, hope everyone definitely will follow this module. And while following this module, please concentrate on the board and on my lecture, time to time, second to second, promptly. So, in this particular topic, so as it is the topic meant for today, chemical properties of carbon compounds, mainly we are going to focus on four important properties. How many properties, my dear students? Four important properties of carbon compounds. What is the first property? Yes, very, very important. This is quite often in our life, every aspect, maximum aspects are linked with this first chemical property and plays a prominent role in our day-to-day life. What is that? Combustion reaction. What is that, my dear? Combustion. And the second one is oxidation. What is the second property, my dear students? Oxidation. And the third one is addition reaction. And the fourth one and the last one is substitution reaction. Yes. So, these are the four important chemical properties of carbon compounds. So, which are prescribed in our textbook introduced by the CBSE board. What are they? Combustion, oxidation, addition, substitution. Now, let us discuss about combustion. The very first chemical property, you know, my dear students, what is meant by combustion? So, let me write this one as separate heading, combustion. What do you understand by the word combustion? Yes, simple, quite simple. Combustion means burning. Do you know what is the meaning of combustion, my dear students? Burning. Burning of any carbon material in the presence of sufficient supply of oxygen to produce heat energy, light energy, along with carbon dioxide and water. So that's this reaction is called combustion. For suppose, let me take one beautiful example in order to illustrate this combustion, my dear students. Coal. Let me take coal. So actually, what is coal? What is coal, my dear students? Coal is one of the allotropic form of carbon. Coal formation takes place millions years ago, and this coal is formed in the earth crust under some depth. So how coal formation takes place in general? The dead plants or the animals which got buried under the earth, influenced by much pressure and temperature, and the dead remains undergo these local effect of conditions of temperature and pressure and slowly converted to coal. And you know, this coal is very important in nowadays. Why? In order to run the thermal power projects to produce electricity, we are using coal. And you know, this coal is the allotropic form of carbon. So whenever this coal, if you take, because coal symbol, if you take the symbol of coal is C. And this carbon in the form of coal burns in the presence of oxygen to produce one gas. What is that gas called? Carbon dioxide. Along with more amount of heat energy and light energy released. So our purpose is this one. But along with our purpose, there is a pollutant which released into the atmosphere, and it causes greenhouse effect, global warming and acid rain. So pollution. So burning of fuels causes pollution along with our purpose served. So this is about the first important example for combustion. Now let me take one more example in the same way. Methane. You know what is methane, my dear students? With the formula CH4, the simplest hydrocarbon. Methane is also called marsh gas because it is obtained from the marshy lands, marshy places, wetlands. Yes, that's why it is called marsh gas. And the main component present in compressed natural gas or natural gas. Okay, now coming to this methane, as usual, methane burns in the presence of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide along with water vapor, followed by heat energy and light energy. Yes, yes. So this is the second chemical equation. So methane undergo combustion in the presence of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water vapor, along with heat energy and light energy. In a similar manner, alcohol. So one of the main member of alcohol family is ethanol. What is the formula of ethanol? C2H5OH also undergo combustion in the presence of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide, water vapor, along with heat energy and light energy. Yes. So this is about the third example. So in all the three examples, whether you notice it or not, the main product of combustion is carbon dioxide. And the byproduct of combustion is water vapor. And what is the purpose served means heat energy and light energy. Now coming to the point. There are two types of hydrocarbons, you know very well. Saturated. What is the other one? Unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons burns with a clean blue flame. Once again, saturated hydrocarbons burns with blue flame. What is that, my dear students? Blue flame. Clean blue flame. Pale blue flame. What is the reason? What is the reason? Whereas unsaturated hydrocarbons burns with yellow flame. Yellow flame. With lots of smoke. Yellow flame with lots of smoke. Yellow flame is also called sooty flame. So what is the reason for sooty flame? And what might be the reason for blue flame? Very simple. The reason might have explained on the basis of saturated hydrocarbons. In saturated hydrocarbons, the amount of carbon percentage is less and the amount of hydrogen content is more. Due to the presence of more content of hydrogen, saturated hydrocarbons burns with the blue flame. What is that? So, more content or amount of content of hydrogen gas. Whereas in unsaturated hydrocarbons, the amount of hydrogen is less content of hydrogen gas and more content of carbon. So, in saturated hydrocarbons, amount of carbon is less and the amount of hydrogen is more, so that the flame produced is blue. Whereas in unsaturated hydrocarbons, the amount of carbon is more and the amount of hydrogen is less. That's why the flame produced is yellow. Yellow flame is also called sooty flame because along with flame, some soot particles also released. Whenever you keep a plate on that sooty flame, if you observe the bottom part of the plate is being covered with sooty deposit, black deposit, which is called in Telugu masi. Yes. So this is mainly because of these sooty particles, soot deposits. Okay. And now sometimes even saturated hydrocarbons also produce yellow flame. But in which condition? If the supply of oxygen is not fruitful, if the supply of oxygen is not sufficient, in spite of causing complete combustion, it causes incomplete combustion. So here saturated hydrocarbons undergo complete combustion, whereas unsaturated hydrocarbons undergo incomplete combustion. Sometimes saturated hydrocarbons undergo incomplete combustion in the insufficient supply of oxygen, that saturated will give yellow flame only. And in that case, there is a need for us to adjust air holes in a burner. Sometimes in burner, in that air holes, if any matter is stuck, sufficient supply of oxygen is not possible to proceed. So we have to clean that burner again, and if you go for combustion, then again we will get blue flame. So this is one of the very important theme for our regular works. Okay. And now coming to the second chemical reaction. What is that? What is the second chemical property, my dear students? Oxidation. Okay, na? Oxidation. Yes. Now, coming to oxidation. In general, what is oxidation? You have already learned this concept from chapter 1, my dear. What is oxidation? Addition of oxygen to any substance. Yes. Addition of oxygen to any substance is called oxidation. And this oxidation is also called controlled combustion. controlled combustion. What is the other name of oxidation? Controlled combustion is also called oxidation. Now, generally, this oxidation process is used to convert alcohols to carboxylic acids. What is that? Alcohols to carboxylic acids. Now, let me take example with the equation. What is that alcohol? Ethanol, C2H5OH. Now, I am adding one oxidizing agent to this. What is that oxidizing agent? Here, two agents are there. One is alkaline potassium permanganate, KMnO4. And what is the second oxidizing agent? Acidified potassium dichromate plus heat. Yes. By taking 5 ml of alcohol in one test tube, if you add 3 or 4 drops of either of the reagents, what is the color of this potassium permanganate and acidified potassium dichromate? Generally pink. After adding to alcohol, then what is the role played by these two agents? What is the duty? They will supply 2 atoms of nascent oxygen to ethanol. Do you know what is nascent? Nascent. Nascent. N-A-S-C-E-N-T. Nascent oxygen. Do you know what is the meaning of nascent oxygen, my dear? Nascent means newly produced, newly bonded. So, this oxygen is produced from either potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate. After adding to this one, this oxygen oxidizes ethanol so that ethanol gradually converted to ethanoic acid along with water. Now, there is a question raised by you. What is that? Sir, in what way we will know whether reaction proceeded or not? We don't know actually whether reaction proceeded or not. How we come to know that whether reaction has taken place or not? For that, there is an observation. What is the observation? Before the reaction, what is the color? Pink. After the reaction, pink color slowly discharged, decolorize, and you will get colorless solution. So that pink color fade out and you will get a colorless solution. And now tell me, what name is given to these alkaline potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate? Yes, you are correct. These are called oxidizing agents. What are oxidizing agents? The substances which are capable to add oxygen to other substances are called oxidizing agents. Here, important oxidizing agents are alkaline potassium permanganate or acidified potassium dichromate. So, this is called oxidation reaction. So, oxidation reaction is mainly meant for the conversion of alcohols to carboxylic acids. Here the alcohol used is ethanol, the carboxylic acid obtained is ethanoic acid. Okay now, my dear students, this is about first two chemical properties of carbon compounds. What are they? One is combustion, second one is oxidation. Now, let me go to third important chemical property, which is very important from board point of view. What is the third important chemical property? What is that important third chemical property? 3. Addition reaction. Addition reaction. Very important, my dear. So, focus more attention. Addition reaction. This addition reaction is meant for generally unsaturated hydrocarbons, which consisting of either double bonds or triple bonds. Yes. Addition reactions are mainly meant for unsaturated hydrocarbons. Now, during this reaction, what you will do? We need to convert unsaturated hydrocarbons to saturated hydrocarbons. This is about conversion. Unsaturated hydrocarbons to saturated hydrocarbons by adding hydrogen gas in the presence of one catalyst. What is the catalyst name? Here few important catalysts are there. Let me list out that one. One is nickel. Second one is platinum. Third one is palladium. These are called catalysts. Now tell me, there is a doubt. What is catalyst? Very simple. It is a chemical substance which speed ups the chemical reaction rate, but without undergoing any change. So these catalyst does not mix up with the reactants, but facilitate the reaction rate. Sometimes increases, sometimes decreases. Generally, catalysts are added to the chemical reactions to speed up the reaction rate. And this is the role played by catalyst in the chemical reaction. It does not undergo any chemical change, but speed up or decreases the speed in few cases on the basis of the priority. So here these are the main catalysts used for addition reaction. Now let me explain by taking one example. All of you observe this side. Let me select one unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now my favorite unsaturated hydrocarbon is ethene. Do you know, my dear students, ethene is the first member of which family? Alkene family. I am adding hydrogen gas in the presence of nickel catalyst. Then what will happen? What is the product obtained? What is the name of the product? Tell me. Very simple. Here there is a double bond. That's why it is called unsaturated hydrocarbon. But during this reaction, this double bond breaks down, breaks up into single bond. Double bond breaks down into single bond. Already first carbon consisting of how many hydrogen atoms, my dear? Two hydrogens are there. Even for second carbon also, two hydrogens are present. And now this hydrogen gas split up into two hydrogen atoms like this. One hydrogen atom is added to the first carbon. Second hydrogen atom is added to the second carbon. So as to satisfy the tetravalency of carbon. You know, carbon is tetravalent. And what is the name of this one? This is called ethane. Because, no, this is saturated hydrocarbon ethane. This is ethene. Ethene is one of the best example for unsaturated hydrocarbon. In that way, we are converting unsaturated hydrocarbons to saturated hydrocarbons. But where you are using this reaction? For industrial purpose. In one industry, you are using this reaction. What is that industry? Industrially, this reaction plays a prominent role. We are using this reaction in the industry for the conversion of vegetable oils into margarine, vanaspati ghee, also called dalda. And what is this name called? Hydrogenation of oils. What is the name, special name of this process, Nana? Hydrogenation of oils. So hydrogenation of oils is one of the industrial application of which reaction? Addition reaction. Now let me explain about that reaction. You know, vegetable oil, which are unsaturated compounds. Vegetable oils are long chained unsaturated compounds which contain double bonds. Okay. Now, by adding hydrogen gas in the presence of any one of the catalysts like nickel, platinum, palladium, then this vegetable oil, which is present in liquid state, gradually converted to fat, which is present in solid state. So, in order to convert vegetable oils to semi-solid fats like dalda, vanaspati ghee, margarine, we are using this addition reaction. Now let me explain that reaction. C, double bond C, R, these R's are alkyl groups, yes, plus we are passing hydrogen gas in the presence of nickel catalyst, then automatically what happened? Double bond break down into single bond, and two remaining R groups are like this, alkyl groups are like this, and this hydrogen split up into two hydrogen atoms, link up to either of the carbons like this, and this is called fat, dalda, and this is called oil. So generally this reaction is used to convert vegetable oils to semi-solid fats called vanaspati ghee or dalda or margarine. In that way, addition reaction is very useful. And there is a doubt, my dear students, for me especially. What is my doubt means, in these two, vegetable oils and saturated fats, which one is good for our health? Yes, generally vegetable oils are good. Oils consisting of double bond, which is good for the health. And saturated fats are bad for the health. And if you take more saturated fats, you become unhealthy. That's why you prefer always vegetable oils. Okay. So this is about the addition reaction. Now we are almost all moving to the final set of this chemical properties of carbon compounds. What is that? Substitution reaction. What is that, my dear student? Substitution reaction. Do you know what is the meaning of substitution, Nana? Yes, substitution. Substitution means what? An atom or group of atoms are replaced by another atom or group of atoms is called substitution. Even while playing the cricket game or football, if any player will get injury, leg injury or hand injury, definitely the captain replacing that player with another player, fit player. Yes or no? That is also called substitution. Even in pro kabaddi also, after 3 minutes or 4 minutes or 10 minutes after, umpire is saying like this, no? First substitution. Why? Because if the player is sick or if the player is unable to perform in the activity, then we are able to replace. Like that here also same. Substitution means atom or group of atoms are replaced by another atom or group of atoms. Now, these substitution reactions are mainly meant for saturated hydrocarbons, especially like alkanes. Alkanes undergo substitution. But generally, alkanes are less reactive. Alkanes are less reactive. That's why alkanes are called paraffins. Do you know why alkanes are called paraffins? Param means little, affins means affinity towards chemical reaction. Since these alkanes are less reactive towards the chemical reaction, also called paraffins, less reactive. Then if these alkanes are less reactive, how these alkanes are being substituted by other reagents? That's why for these reactions we are using, generally these reactions are proceed in the presence of God sun. That is called sunlight radiation. Yes. So in the presence of sunlight, alkanes undergo substitution with different reagents and replacement takes place time to time. Now let me explain that by taking one simple example, my dear. All of you concentrate here. Now let me take the first member of alkane. What is that? Methane. So let us take methane as the example for this. So what is methane? The simplest hydrocarbon, especially belongs to alkane. Now this methane undergoes substitution with chlorine gas in the presence of sunlight. Yes. Now we are adding chlorine gas to methane gas. Then automatically in the presence of sunlight, reaction proceeds. And because of this reaction, what would happen? Now let me explain. In methane, how many hydrogens are attached to carbon? There are 4 hydrogen atoms. But out of these 4 hydrogen atoms, one of the hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine atom. So that you will get the first product as CH3Cl along with hydrogen chloride gas is obtained. Because here one hydrogen replaced, no? Here one chlorine is left free. Both the hydrogen and chlorine get together to form HCl. And this is about the first step. In the second step, the first product CH3Cl again undergo substitution in the presence of sunlight with chlorine gas. So that in the second step, what would happen? CH2, Cl2 plus HCl gas is obtained. Why CH2, Cl2? Because one more substitution takes place. Actually, number of hydrogens are 3. One hydrogen atom is being replaced by chlorine atom. Then, automatically hydrogen number decreases, chlorine number increases. This is the case of substitution. In the third step, what is the main product here? This is called dichloromethane. This is called chloromethane. This is called dichloromethane. Now let me take dichloromethane, CH2Cl. Again I am adding chlorine gas in the presence of sunlight. Again this leads to substitution reaction to form CHCl3. One more hydrogen is being replaced by chlorine atom. So that the second product is HCl gas as usual. And what name is given to this one? Trichloromethane. See, chloromethane, dichloromethane, trichloromethane. This trichloromethane is also called chloroform, which is used as anesthetic agent. And in the fourth step, I am taking this as a main product, main reactant, CHCl3, on addition with chlorine gas in the presence of sunlight, undergo again substitution. But during this substitution, the last hydrogen atom also being replaced by chlorine atom. So that you will get CCl4HCl. Now, my dear students, do you observe, Nanu? Is there any place for hydrogen left? No. All the hydrogens present in methane are being replaced by chlorine atoms step to step. So, there are 4 steps in this actual reaction. And the first step is called chain initiation reaction. Second step and third steps are collectively called chain propagation reactions. And the last step is called chain termination. You know, my dear students, what is the meaning of termination? Termination means ending. So this is called chain reaction, specially meant for alkanes. So out of alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, which one undergoes substitution? What is your answer? Yes, you are right, alkanes. Which one undergo addition reactions? Both alkenes as well as alkynes. Both alkenes as well as alkynes. Because these are unsaturated, these are saturated. This is meant for hydrogenation of oils. This is meant for preparation of different chlorine related products, like this step by step. But for suppose if you want to replace chlorine gas with bromine, you will get bromine related products. If you want to substitute with fluorine, you will get fluorine related products. If you want to substitute it with iodine, you will get iodine related products. Okay now, my dear students, this is about today's module, specially about chemical properties of carbon compounds. What are the 4 chemical properties, my dear? First one is combustion, second one is oxidation, third one is addition reaction, fourth one is substitution. So hope everyone understood all the 4 properties, which are very important from the examination point of view. So tomorrow we shall discuss about some important carbon compounds for commercial purpose. Till then, my dear students, have a nice day. Thank you.